before I forget this at the end, that the committee of people who helped, as you can see, this is a big event, and who helped put this together for us, I cannot thank you enough. The Lee County Sheriff's Office and their tremendous help in getting this done, court ops, court security, court administration, and Linda Doggett. By the way, this is Clerk of Court, Linda Doggett's jury assembly room, and she was incredibly gracious in allowing us to use it, not to mention having to field some slightly hysterical phone calls from me a few nights ago when I didn't think we had enough room, which we didn't, obviously, in the other courtrooms. And the same team chief did give thank you. He had to field also some phone calls from me that night. And to my SAO staff who helped put this together, thank you so much to you also. Judge McHugh, I want to thank you for our many, many years of working together. You are an absolutely wonderful jurist, and you have done a tremendous job as chief judge. I think that all your fellow judges would agree with me with that, and it's been wonderful to have your friendship for so many years. Thank you. And Judge Chappell, what can I say? Thank you so much for your beautiful words. We go back a really long way. I remember sitting in the back of a car coming back from the East Coast. We had gone on a trip together, and I had a felony trial coming up. And I sat in the back seat with her and asked her questions on how I should do certain things in the trial. And of course, with her assistance, I mean, I think it was about a 1 minute guilty verdict after I got her. she has been a tremendous friend to me and a tremendous mentor. And it has been my true privilege to be able to appear in front of you, not only when you were a county court judge here in this building, but also as a federal district court judge. And thank you so much for our many years of friendship. And to all the other judges sitting over there, I've known many of you for so many years. Nick, you are grinning at me. Judge Thompson, excuse me. Judge Thompson's investiture, and under strict instruction not to tell certain stories. No, but so many of you over there have been such a huge influence in my career. I started back in 1990 on the same day as Judge Gonzalez, who already announced that, and Judge Sweat. And it's just been a great, great time of my career to be able to spend it with all of you. So I thank you all very much. I look forward to our new judges who have just taken the bench and developing that type of relationship with you. So thank you very much to all of you and all the guidance you've provided me over the years when I could be doing things better. So thank you. Joe D, you're next. Joe, former state attorney Joe D'Alessandro. He hired me. He gave me my first opportunity. I started fresh out of law school in 1990. I took the auto train here, reported to my first day at work a couple days after I graduated from law school, met Joe D'Alessandro, and he was a guiding force in my career. He provided great mentorship to me, and he taught me something very, very important early on, which is that the prosecutor is the minister of justice. That's what he would tell us. He told us that on our first day, and we followed it every single day, and I follow it every day to this time, and that without a fair and just prosecutor, the entire criminal justice system fails. So Joe, thank you for providing me the opportunity to work with you for 12 years, and you really formed the basis of my career. I'll never be able to thank you enough. You made me the first female head of the Collier County office, which was one of the really true honors of my career. So thank you. And Steve, I could never have hoped for a better boss than you. You, I think many, many people in this room can attest to this. You have been an absolutely excellent state attorney. I cannot imagine having anyone more strong to follow in the footsteps of you and Joe. And what you have shown me every day is the compassion that it takes, the wisdom that it takes, and the truly good heart that it takes to be an excellent public official. And I think that we can all agree on that. I know you always tell me that I'm over-exaggerating every time I give a speech about you, but I don't think anyone in this room would think that I was over-exaggerating with those words about Steve. Steve, thank you for giving me this opportunity. Thank you for the beautiful words you said about me. And I hope that I will make you very, very proud and make you very, very proud, Joe, as I follow in both of your footsteps. Thank you. you provide, I know anytime anyone needs a speaker and they get Larry Hart, they know the first thing he's gonna do is make everyone laugh, because he is a very gifted man. Not only was he an awesome law enforcement officer when he was FMPD police chief, awesome tax collector, but I always tease him that he really did miss his calling as a stand-up. So Larry, I will try very hard not to call you back in front of a grand jury, as other state attorneys might have done in the past. Your addition to our community is just tremendous and cannot even be put in. Sheriff Marcino, I want to thank you for letting us use your honor guard. They, as usual, have done such a tremendous job, and your agency does a tremendous job every day. I thank you very much for that, and it was a beautiful start to the ceremony. And General Dozier, thank you for your service and for your leading of the pledge to us. I think it was very special to everyone here to have an American hero such as you lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance. Thank you very much for that. And Aaron Hughes, what a beautiful voice, right? Thank you so much. Aaron, by the way, is an assistant state attorney in the Lee County Felony Division, and we have some very talented musical attorneys. We have a band. The singer of our band is Miss Gray. But thank you, Aaron. That was beautiful. Very much appreciated. And Doris Portiz, you're one of my greatest friends. Thank you so much for that absolutely beautiful prayer. I think you really captured the essence of what it is to be a public servant and what it is to be a prosecutor. And you just couldn't have said it more beautifully. You've been a wonderful friend to me, and I thank you so very much. You and your wonderful husband, Wally, who's also an American hero, World War II and Korea War vet, and we thank you so much. Thank you, Doris. Now I want to say to our other law enforcement officials who are here, first of all, former Sheriff Mike Scott could not be here, but I know that his family is here. I see his wonderful mother and his daughter, Lindsay. If I'm missing someone, I'm sorry, but to former Sheriff Scott, current Sheriff Carmine Marcino, Sheriff Kevin Rambos from Collier County, Sheriff Steve Whitten from Hendry County, Sheriff Dave Hardin and Sheriff Bill Prevelt from Glades and Charlotte weren't able to be with us today, but we have many of our fine other law enforcement officials here today. Our police chiefs from Sanibel, Chief Dalton, Chief Shatino from Marco Island, Chief Davis, Chief Weschler, and I think I saw Chief Newland there in the back. Don't even tell me I missed a chief. Thank you to all of you and any other law enforcement officer. I see many of you here in this room. I know you all know this. Any of you who are hearing me for the 10 millionth time say this, I apologize, but some of you may not have heard me say this, and I want to give our law enforcement in the room credit, and I want to give our public officials who are in the room credit. There's many councilmen here, our commissioners, representatives. This is because of all of you and all of you as law-abiding citizens, but because of this tremendously good law enforcement we have here, excellent law enforcement in this circuit, many of whom are sitting here with us today, standing here with us today. This circuit, the five counties, has had the lowest crime rate out of any of the 20 circuits in Florida for 6 years in a row, and that's so one of the things I am most excited about as I enter down this path is the relationship with law enforcement and the way we have worked together and how strong we are together. And I know that we will continue to build it more and more until we have the lowest crime rate in the whole United States. That's what we're going to do. I see a lot of faces from the SAO out there as I look around, many, many of my coworkers. I really wish that I could have every single one of you up here with me, because this is because of you. Part of the reason there's that low crime rate is because of you. Your work, your incredible work, day in and day out,